wellness. So he's requested that you know, he would like to make a 5-minute presentation. I request you to please quick, sir, so that we can have some more discussion on what you presented.
Thank you so much. I'll take maybe less than 5 minutes, and if you feel at any point of time I'm boring, raise your hand, I'll keep my mouth shut. Is that a good deal? Is it working? I know, can you hear me?
Yes.
That's great. As I say, there are three very difficult things to do in life. One is very, very difficult to climb a wall which is leaning towards you. Right? Very easy to climb a wall which is leaning away from you. Very difficult to sit all day in a conference and keep getting a lot of information. See, she's smiling and laughing. And third is very difficult for me to speak when you see lunch on your left hand side. But let me share with you a little bit what we are doing in a real way, making an impact, because everything what we do is with a purpose, supporting a cause. And that is the reason I thought, let me share with you practically what we are doing and how we are creating a little bit of impact. And that's where it starts with the vision. The vision we said was, let's heal the world. When we did this, people were thinking, we are idiots. I said, let's be idiots. Let people think whatever we are. But let's think big. And then we said, let's make sure everyone in the chain wins. Whether it's Mother Earth, farmers, customers, consumers, team members, and society or environment as a whole. Very easy to write. Then we realized what to do, how to do. We went to the remotest village of our country with literally zero infrastructure. Village Baba I have never come across. Zero infrastructure, power is an issue, water is an issue. In fact, even a dog we could see after 2 years of our operational existence over there. Literally what we saw was sometimes a bakri or a bhans and few farmers here and there. We realized if we have to be in authentic organic to really create an impact, let's be over there. The challenges were, there is farmer suicides happening all around. Authentic products are not available. Sustainability is a major issue. Yes, easy to set up a plant in a big city where everything is available to you. But we went over there. Coming to the employment, the children over there, the youth or the unemployed youth over there, they were coming all the way to big cities, creating pains and pressure in the big cities as well as for the families which are staying back over there. We provided the employment to them. Uneducated so-called, they are running the plant today over there. And above all, customers getting authentic organic products. We moved away from the so-called machines to hand-grounded raw material, which is really the historical or the legacy of India. Ab gaon mein chakki chalai ja rahi hai. What you get from organic wellness is a dal which is hand-grounded. It is self-sustainable, it is good for the mother or the women in the farm or in the villages who are operating that. There is no power. The easiest way was to set up a generator. It is easier, faster, better. No, we went for the solar panels, we went for the high tension connection. We went for a plant which is modern, and even at high temperatures of 50 degrees centigrade, we don't use any air conditioner. You can see the modern plant in front of you. We have got all the possible world-class certificates. We have regular audits happening over there. And this is what we have been able to really create and connect with the local people who were otherwise unemployed and living on nothing. Exporting to many countries, I'll skip. This is my effectively boardroom sitting below a banyan tree which is over 500 years old. We have got visitors coming across the world, and I have got zero power bill. The best time people really have is meeting, managing our plant and operations sitting below this tree. You are most welcome to come and have fun. Certainly you will find better than this look, this comfort also. We have got regular visitors coming across from the world as well as in India, and you can see the way we manage. We are talking about plastic-free villages. We did it already a couple of years back. Many villages are in the pipeline and already many are done. You can see some of the villages we have made plastic free over last couple of years. Children at the base, they are using MacBooks. Sustainability. We are moving from plastics to the Dona Patal in the areas wherever we are connecting, and you will be amazed. People are really loving it, liking it. Their profitabilities are also going up. We are catching young. We are going to the schools, sharing with the people, sharing with the kids the benefit of the sustainability or the value chain I call about going to the villages. Now, the most important part is engaging with the customers. Tea bags. We talk to a customer. We talk to people by using a tea bag. Why not just tea directly? It's just the marketing, the way it was done. If I talk to 100 people, I'm telling you 90 people, they say, from tomorrow I'm using just the loose tea. It's not required. Then they ask, it's unbleached paper, it's a bleached paper, it's an aluminum paper. But man, use just the tea directly. I suppose that's where the education or the engagement with the customers is required. Cartons or secondary packaging. Every toothpaste, every cream comes with a carton with zero value addition. I suppose everyone sitting over here, you have to speak your voice. Make sure you pick up the product from a company which is really caring. It's a reduction of raw material cost, packaging material cost, sustainability. And if you see what we are doing, this is the range of products we have. Minimizing the packaging everywhere, reusing it, recycling it, and every bottle a customer brings in, we give him a special discount and encouragement so that people bring in bottles back to the company or they reuse in their kitchen or wherever they feel fit. In short, a company with a cause, a company with a purpose, and in short, thank you so much. I have taken not more than 3-5 minutes. And I hope in case you had any questions during lunchtime, I'm always available. And in last, I would say one thing which is very, very close to my heart. I was with my father standing near the Marine Drive in Mumbai during my first job. It's a big multinational company. I was very delighted coming from a, you know, B school and blah, blah, blah. He came to drop me. He picked up some calcium carbonate. He says, beta, from today, you will also start fooling our country. You will be selling this 10 rupee kg product for 2000 rupees a kg. I said, to hell with, he is not even understanding that I am, you know, a big guy now. I am a management trainee in some big company. That was always hitting me. He says, always do work with a purpose, with a cause. When I was standing near the Barren Drive, he asked me, you know what this ship, this steamer, needs to always keep moving. I kept telling you, engine, oil, diesel, he said it's water. If there is no water, it will not sail. But the day the water comes inside the steamer, it sinks. Same is the case with us. Money is very, very important to us. But the day the money comes in our heart, that starts sinking. And that's what is happening in our world. It's chasing the money, chasing the commercials, which is great, but it should not be entering the heart of us. Thank you so much once again. Thank you.
Thank you. So I think we had one round of sharing.